Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 872, and today's topic is the industrial manufacture of Portland cement, which is commonly known as cement. Cement is the mixture of several substances, and once it is mixed with water or any liquid, it has plastic property of flowing. It has plastic flow property, and once it is given few hours time, it will become hard and solid, and it will give rigid solid structure. And Egyptian, Romans and British, they were using the rock of the volcano. They will just collect the rock and they are burned silicate and clay, lime, and it was powdered and it was used as a binding material. But in 1924, one gentleman in England, he started manufacturing artificially. So only from 1924 they started using the manufacture of cement artificially. Otherwise, before that only natural cements were used, and those were the powder material of volcanic rock, which were the burned silicate, and it got the name because when the silicate and some lime stone was powdered, and when it was mixed with water, and then it had the flow property and solidified very hard structure, and that looked like their Portland rock in England. From that day, they gave the name Portland cement. So from there the word Portland came. So here it is, industrial manufacture of Portland cement. Number one, cement is general term given to the powdered materials which initially had plastic flow. So the word cement is given to such type of materials. They are the mixture of different chemical substances, compounds, which are having plastic flow. Once it is mixed with any liquid like water or any other solvent, when mixed with water or other liquid, but has the property of setting to a hard solid structure in few hours time. So once it will be flow like a liquid, but after some time, maybe within 4 or 5 hours time, if you leave it, it will become very hard and solid, rigid structure with varying degree of strength and bonding properties. Varying degree of strength and bonding properties means it depends upon the ratio of the cement and some other binding material like silicon dioxide, that is called sand. So if you are taking 4:1, means 4% cement and 1% sand, it will be very strong and rigid with high strength. If you are taking 3% of sand and only 1% of cement, of course its rigidity will be not like one which is having more cement percentage. The strength and bonding properties. Greek, Romans and Egyptians used volcanic stuff such as pulvenic cement. So pulvenic cement is volcanic stuff near Pozzolina. I mean that's Pozzolina in Italy. So actually near Italy they have very big volcanic space where volcanic eruption is there, and lot of volcanic rocks are collected. So with that name, they have given the name to that natural cement, and at that time, ancient time, there was nothing like industrial manufacture or artificial cement. They were using only volcanic rocks in powder form. And that volcanic rock was called pozzolanic cement. So pozzolanic cement means that is pozzolanic cement was obtained from the place where volcanic eruption rock was there. That place is in Italy, named as Pozzolani. And this type of natural cement may be regarded as mixture of burnt silicate and lime. So all these natural cements, that is volcanic rock, they were nothing but the burnt silicate and lime, and the acidic siliceous matter combines with calcium hydroxide. So that rock was acidic material, and it was combining with calcium hydroxide during the setting of natural cement. And a cement of the more setting and much greater extent was discovered by the scientist known as Joseph Aspidine. So Joseph Aspidine, he was the one who discovered the formula of synthetic or artificial cement in the year 1924. And from the year 1924, they have started using his formula, and that is known as Portland cement. And this cement is called Portland cement. And nowadays, this cement is prepared artificially. Portland cement is more of the is one of the most important building material. So here number two, about the Portland cement. Joseph Aspidine was the chemist who discovered the Portland cement formula. Found that a strongly heated mixture of limestone and clay. So he discovered that once limestone clay is strongly heated and mixed with a small amount of water, set in few hours to a hard stone-like substance. After setting, the stone-like mass is resembled to a famous Portland rock in stone of England. So he found that once that limestone and clay heated one, and then by putting a small amount of water, after some time when it becomes hard like a stone, it resembles like one place, that is Portland rock stone was found in England, and that's why he gave the name Portland cement. So the word Portland cement came from the stone rock of England, the place Portland where stone rock is there in UK. And hence it was named as Portland cement. And even today this word is widely used. This cement is chemically defined as the powdered mixture of calcium, aluminate and silicates of various compositions. So it is actually the mixture of powder, calcium, aluminate and silicates with different composition, which hydrate when mixed with water to form a rigid solid structure with good compressive strength. Portland cement is mixture of following compounds. So here I have given the Portland cement is the mixture of these following compounds. The one formula what they give is called CaSiO2, and they give the abbreviation, that is C2S, and it is the dicalcium silicate. Second one is 3CO SiO2, abbreviation is C3S, and it is called tricalcium silicate. Then third one is 3CaO L2O3, it is called C3A, and it is called tricalcium aluminate. That is the name of those compounds, and this is the abbreviation. And the fourth one is MgO, it has no abbreviation, and it is called magnesium oxide. And the fifth one, CO, it has no abbreviation, and it is called calcium oxide. So this mixture of compounds are known as Portland cement. So one group of cements, they are the mixture of these compounds, and they are called as Portland cement. And the other formulations, they are known as other type of cements. So here I have given the formulation of and introduction, know-how about the Portland cement. And in the next lecture, I will be discussing the other type of formulation of other cements. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture. And here I have already told you in the beginning that nowadays I am delivering the lecture on industrial chemistry. So different type of industries I am discussing. Now I have started the industrial manufacture of cement, that is cement industry. Once again, thank you very much for watching the lecture.